Ara,
ara. Hey Squid, hi chat.
Ara, ara.
Squid Ink, hey.
Ara, ara. Ara, ara.
Yeah, mommy Squid is back to take care of us ink sacks. Please don't go to get milk and cigarettes again. You were gone for so long, Squid Ink love.
Ara, ara.
I am in love with Renee Rapp and welcome back, Squid.
Oopsies, everything in my OBS reset today, and I did not think about the fact.
Wait, you know what's so awkward is I've been talking for like 2 minutes, and I was like, no one acknowledges me. I was like, no one likes me. That's so, hold up, we're trying this again. hold up. Yo, that song is All Too Well by Renee Rapp. What the fuck is up, gamers? How we doing today? Scarlett, thank you for the 10 months. I am also in love with fucking... Screaming does not make your live room muted. Fuck off, Metal Mind. Eat my little tootsies. Scarlett, thank you for the 10 months. Spam, thank you for the 13. Please leave. Thank you for the 3. Sarah, thank you for the motherfucking red. Baby God, how you doing? Wiz, thank you for the 3 months. Gia, thank you for the 14. Hello, everybody. I guess I should, show you my face that you absolutely haven't seen before. I'm so glad I was muted, though, because I was singing and I wasn't muted at first. And I was like, oh, no, they hear me. Hello! Oh, no, the stream with no risk. Fuck off. I'm so happy I'm still online. Yeah, I'm so sorry. I took a break. I took a little break, but I'm back now. Hello! She did a whole radio show. My dad growing up used to say that I had a face for radio, and I didn't realize until I was an adult that he meant I was ugly. Hello! Also, Camden, thank you for the fucking 4 months. How are we doing? George, you're a funny woman. Thank you. I also think I'm a funny woman. There's so many new people here. Hello, how are you doing? How are you doing? The fucking Rizzler is back. I want to get a Rizzler costume. Will someone make that for me? I'll pay you. Oh, took you that long? Yeah. Wait, what? Yeah, what took me long? I lasted a long... What is the question? What took me a long time? I'm confused. Okay, let me turn this down. Kevin, thank you for the prime, baby girl. Okay, ooh, sneeze clip. That clip did way better than I was expecting it to, and now I feel like I need to make a compilation of me sneezing on stream. Do I have newts? What a wonderful question, cute smiles. Welcome on in. I'm having a wonderful day. Thank you for asking. No, I will never ever sell nudes on the internet, nor do I have them. That is not something I do, not something I appreciate. But you know what I do appreciate? The little block button that I have. So get banned, fucker. Do not ask me for nudes. You're never gonna get them. Fuck you. Hello, everybody. Mika! 16 months. Oh, my God. And Angel, thank you for the 5. Oh, my God. There's so many subs right now. What the fuck? Hi, everybody. Is anyone going to notice that I'm leaking something right now? And it's not piss. The goat is back. Surprisingly. Is anyone going to notice? Hey, whoa there. Whoa there, buddy boy. Whoa there, buddy boy. Whoa there, buddy boy. Vin, thank you for the fucking 5 subs, baby. How are you doing? Whoa, what a cool shirt. Is that potential squid ink? Guys, hey, Rajar, thank you for the 9 months. I missed you too. How are you doing? Your family's noticed? Thanks, Mom. You noticed on FaceTime. My parents called me about 2 minutes before I started stream, and it was great. I loved it so much. I love it. Hello, Gideon, thank you for the 10 gifted. Okay, there's so much going on right now. Hi, I missed you all. I missed you all. Asia, thank you for the gifted. Thank you for the gifted. Hi, I miss you guys. We have so much to catch up on. I'm still gay though, so don't worry. Not that much has changed. But Scarlett, thank you for the 5 gifted. Scarlett, I was thinking about you the other day, and I can't remember why, but I was. I think I was thinking about rowing or something. I don't know. Josh! Thank you for the 15. 15? That's like more than 2. It is. I missed you guys. Hold up. I missed you so much. I've missed this. I'm so nervous right now. I don't know about y'all. Do you guys ever like, you know how you're in a cat, like a class every single day? You know, for those of you who are in university, if you're below university, don't fucking tell me. If you're out of university, congratulations. If you never went to university, slay mama boots. I am jealous. But you know how you like, you're in a class and you're in this class every day, but you get nervous to speak and like you come back from winter break and you're like, it's been a long time. I haven't talked to any of you fuckers in a while. That's how I feel right now. I'm very nervous. I'm like, I know I talk all the time on the internet, but it's been like a month and I'm nervous. Hello. Comrade Trash, thank you. Hello, welcome on in. Also, wait, Sarah, did you continue your sub? Hi, King Kong. Should we do roll call real quick? Poseidon, well, hello, welcome on in. And I'm sorry it's so late. It is only like 8 p.m. for me. Soul, hello. Tris, Sarah, Kalia, hello. UVCW, Buggy is the fucking Rizla. You, Angel, hello. Please leave. Metal Mine, I won't dox myself, I promise. Hex Girl, Requiem, thank you for the fucking sub. King Kong, Joshua, Dopo, Lightning Bike, hello. How are we doing, everybody? Witch, The stream censored the gate. It did not. It could never. McFly, hello. Lindsay, Raptor, Gideon, thank you for the 1,000 bits. Oh my god. Selective Risk, hello. Hello. Thank you for the kind words, by the way, over DM. Spiral, Luna, hello. Bleeblow, Rat. Oh, you guys are doing this so, like, slowly today. It's actually really nice. Heavy.
Wait,
what is up? Red, eat a baby. Still love your username. Still obsessed with it. Thank you. Hello, everybody. Okay. Moody, fuck you. I don't even have my headphones on. Ha 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 ha. This guy, man, your new brother, John, DJ, Noah. Hello. Okay. I said John the Flick. It's Joe. I wasn't ready. I didn't even hear the music till halfway through. Hold up. I'm gonna stand for a sec. Just a little bit. Or just like a little higher. There we go. That's fine. Okay. We have lots to talk about. Hi! Do the Luddy? I do the Luddy all the time. I haven't won your stream so long. I haven't been streaming in so long. There's been a whole month, basically. I streamed twice this month. Why does it make me so insecure that you're good at dancing? You know, I don't know, but you shouldn't be insecure because everyone's good at dancing. I hope you know my entire life, I was told that I'm a bad dancer. Like, I was always criticized for my dancing, and then I went on the internet and I was like, look at the weird moves, and everyone was like, slay! It's been a month. I streamed on like the 4th and the 8th. And that's the last time I streamed. First time I know. Hello, welcome back, Scarlett. We've missed you. Possum, thank you. Thank you for the tip, babe. Welcome back. Thank you. How's everyone doing? How was everyone's holidays? How are you even more adorable live? Genetics, did you have a nice Hanukkah? I had a wonderful Hanukkah. Thank you for fucking asking. Hi, Pars. Hello. Hi, Kat. I had a wonderful Hanukkah. I saw the gift. It's so sick. I have to show you guys one of the gifts that my friends made me. I feel so weird being back. Dead and Kinnick and I are just happy to see you back on as everybody else. Aw, wait, that's so cute. What was my favorite? My favorite gift I got is in the background right now. Hold up. It's not in frame fully. It's right. Oh, shit. So, my friends made me a mini arcade. Not the play button. I forget that I have that so frequently because I have mad imposter syndrome and I don't think I deserve it. But they made me a little arcade and it's branded for me. So I'm gonna find ways to incorporate it into the stream. But it has a bunch of like, hold up. That's super cool, right? Okay, I'm gonna move awkwardly so no one looks at my butt. Thank you. Okay. Like, it has a bunch of games. There's a bunch of Nintendo games. Hold up. Where's the... Ah! Nope. That button? No! I entered Star Wars. Okay. Oopsies. I'm still learning all the controls, but I was playing Street Fighter this morning on it because I love Street Fighter. I'm a slut for Street Fighter. Chun-Li and Poison? Osle. It works too? Yeah, it completely works. I can play games on it whenever. A couple of my friends made it for me. It's really fucking amazing. Yeah, it's like literally you can kind of see it's working right now. So I'm gonna get stuff so I can turn it, like, use it on stream. It's making sounds. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, coolest, Poison's iconic. I'm a Poison main because I like her little whip because she was like, poof. It's the hardest gift I've seen in a minute. Honestly, guys, if I have one recommendation, if you're a gamer or anyone, they made it. So there's a kit that they got to make the, like, box, but they did all of, like, the software and putting it together and everything, and they customized it to my branding. If I have one recommendation for any person on the planet, it is to become friends with fucking software engineers. That is, if you're a software engineer, you're so pockies. Software engineers don't get enough fucking slay. Like, they don't get enough appreciation. They're a slay. They cord organize for me. When I have a problem, they troubleshoot it. They fix everything. And the engineer in general. Be friends with engineers. Date engineers. They're great. Fuck doctors. Engineers are in. I'm going to be a Jewish mother one day, and I swear to God, I'm going to tell my kids, like, you see any nice engineers? Fuck doctors. I don't give a fuck about doctors. Okay? Engineers are where it's at, and I stand by that statement. You can quote me on it. Also, thank you for the 2 months, Galen. Hello. Hello, Yellow Sub. Hello. Yeah, I would take it. I would really like that craze talk. Very much, actually. Very, very much. I'm taking notes. This is... Well, you can have a doctor in engineering. Okay, okay. Monty, hold up. Hold up, buddy. Bestie. You know what I'm trying to fucking say. You're a little goober. You're being a little fucking goober today. And I'm, you know, in the streets, they call me the little goober crusher. You're about to get fucking ba-ba-bang. You're not. Don't worry. Goober, I think, is my word of the week. Goober is my word. Don't make me hydrate. My mom's yelling at me because I don't drink water. Ever. So, it's okay. It was mid. What was mid? How was your stream? I was watching for a little bit. I'm being so, but like, can we like bring back Goober? Call your friends Goobers, like in the best way. This is my cup today. I've been at my parents, so I haven't been home, and so my place is disgusting. You got really frustrated at this game. Ah, look at you. You get frustrated at games. I'm frustrated emotionally, physically, and sexually. It's the perfect combination. I did show some cringe content. What? Speaking of cringe content, can I plug my merch? Is that cool? Can I talk about it? I bet it was awesome. When I was watching, it was fucking slay. You were getting scared, and I love watching you be scared. Yes? Oh, wait, Sarah, I'm gonna watch the VOD then, because I want to see it. Okay. So I don't know if you... Wait, I'm gonna play romantic music. Hold up. Wait. Sorry. Because, like, we're, like, whenever I do ads and stuff, I feel like I play jazz music, so we're gonna do it again. Thank you! Heavy for the fucking 2 months, how you do it? Okay, wait. So. Ooh. Is this sexy? No, wait, actually, this is too sexy. It's making me feel uncomfy. Oh, there we go. Ah! Ooh. Give it to him. Ooh! Okay, so... First off, I don't know if you're aware, baby girl, but I'm dropping merch on January 2nd with the mastermind behind it being Mika Meba, who's in chat right now. They just said, hi, Sarah. You see the little like neon green name there? Super sexy. They are my wonderful, wonderful graphic designer. It is, I would say like our two minds together, but it's me being like, I like colors. And then Mika making the most beautiful thing on the planet. But Corey, thank you for the 12 months. Oh, that's a year, baby. The baby girl's not it. Baby Goyle. Shot it. Why? Okay, but what are the pieces of merch? I just grabbed my boobs. That was not intentional. I'm so sorry. Okay. Greedy. Thank you for the tier one, baby. This is one of the designs. Ooh. It says family friendly content because a bitch is not family friendly whatsoever. I think it's kind of fucking sick. Look at it. Look at the little thing. I have one design that is actually, thank you by the way for the subs. Like, hold up, let me get through this speech and I'm gonna thank everyone. I have, that didn't flow naturally. It's cause I was gonna say shoddy and then it like came out baby girl. It happens. But so how it is, what it does, it'd be so funny if people cropped it. I did crop it. I think it actually comes in a crop top, but we made that decision after I had already ordered this. This is my test merch, so I actually think we moved this design down slightly, but wait, I should have done like a full merch, like a full like actual ad. I should have had this scripted, but basically I'm dropping 3 different styles of merch. 2 of them are based on kind of like jokes of the channel. And then one of them is actual, like it says Squid Ink on it. It has a really awesome design, but for those of you who don't want to wear like fucking cum joke Jewish girl who's gay on the internet that I like, there are options for you. Do we like this? Do we like this? Squidinkadink. It's squidinkadink. Can we see it?
Mika, you don't happen to have like a little leak thing, do you? Because I don't think I could show the site yet.
Dropping January 2nd. I will update you guys more on this. But you have the merch?
I don't have it with me. I literally don't have it with me. I literally don't.
Oh, wait. Kind of, actually. I have the stickers. I left it at my friend's house when I got my gift. Where's Don't Bully Me, I'll Come, Birch? That's not trademarked. Here are the three designs. These are the three designs. Yeah, cat, I made this one for you, baby girl. Thank you guys, Trevor, for the tier one. Snaggle Fox, thank you for the tier one. I like your name a lot. Fish, thank you for the 14 months. What the fuck? There's so many 14 months there. Oh my god. You and Gideon on your shit. Bob and Green Day. My dad tried to take me to a Green Day concert once, and I didn't go. Because I was a stupid idiot who didn't understand good music. That's it, Squid. What do you mean for me? This is fucked up. Kat, I only say that because we relate like so emotionally. Use your... Did you get money for the holidays? Buy my merch. Are you gay and you want other people to know that you're gay? Drop cash money on my merch. Can we know prices? They're not set in stone yet, but I can tell you guys a price range about. So I will say I'm gonna have more of a leak. I will have a proper leak for you guys, but I haven't been here all month, so I haven't gotten to say anything about it, which is fucking stupid of me. I'm really doing this poorly. But Snaggle Fox!
You earned my sub by loving software engies.
Thank you for the tip, my friends. Also, hold up. Kat, I kind of roast the fuck out of you a lot, so I'm going to do something nice real quick. Hold up. You're VIP now, bro. Hold up. Where's my site? How do I do this?
Mika, I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, wait. No, I figured it out. Okay. I'm not showing you guys the site. Be gay. Buy my merch. Is that a good ad? How do you advertise? But, so, the Friend Zone collection is by far the most expensive because it has the most complicated design, which there is a whole... I wish I had my sweatshirt on me. I left it. The cheapest... thing other than stickers, the cheapest piece of clothing right now is $26, but that is subject to change. I'm gonna go through all the prices and adjust everything. The most expensive item is $69, and that is the Friend Zone hoodie. And that's not fucking changing, because the fact that it could be $69 is something that I'm not changing. Like, that's too funny. Hoodie. There are hoodies, there are shirts, there are tank tops, there are stickers, there's a crop top. There's a mix of things. And the second drop, we'll do crew necks and stuff. There's more things to come in the future. This is just the first drop. Dual, no, but that's actually kind of a good idea that I'm kind of saying. The premium hoodie is the, yes, yeah, $59, and it's a simpler version. So there are, we'll go through the site together on stream the day of launch. We will do that.
Thank you, Absinthe, for the gifted sub!
Yes. I also will recommend that you size up on hoodies. I will do, how about this? Chat, we have a deal. On the day of launch, or like maybe the night before, how about we like go through the site or something? I'll update you in the Discord. We'll go through the site. I'll tell you what to size up in. I'll show you all the options. We can talk stuff through. Yeah? Are we down for that? Maybe we'll do it in the Discord. Not live, we'll do it in the Discord or something. We'll figure it out. I think it goes up in what's the largest size? Let me check. The largest size right now that they have is a 3XL. That is just, that is the site that we're working with, Fourth Wall. Hi, Dave. But I can, again, this is just the first launch. If we can try in the future, I don't know how all this stuff works, but I'm not, don't know everything about the size stuff, but I will look into it. I think, Mika, other blanks might have larger size ranges. Yeah, well, and I can look into that. But the blanks that we went with so far only go up into a 3XL. I can see if there is a blank with a larger one with larger sizes. I'm getting it. Your ad convinced me. 69XL, shoddy. Wait, why is this? No! My little soundboard isn't working today. I hope y'all know everything fucking broke right before stream. Mika knows what they're doing. Mika is a, can we get another shout out for Mika? Mika is not only the like most amazing graphic designer on the fucking planet, but they're also an amazing streamer and like do really funny shorts. So if you guys like my shorts, you'll probably like their shorts. Everything broke. Yes, it did. No, it literally, I had to restart my computer twice before stream started. It's like nothing's working today. It's because I haven't been here. I've been, what, did everyone have a good holidays? No, fan, oh my God, I almost just vomited. Slay, do it, do it. Watch my stream during work. It's okay, your boss doesn't have to know. And if they, if your boss comes in, I'll tell them hi. I'll be like, we're just drinking coffee and talk, what do you do? We'll talk about that. We're just talking about the government. I don't, computer is dusty. It's not that dusty. Hi, Roshi, hi, Ro. I love you. I miss you. Mario, yeah, I play music. But, so wait. You're a consultant, if anyone asks. Only thing I consult is your mom, sexually. Sorry. I'm so excited for the merch. I'm so excited. But, oh, we have so much shit to do. I have to make this 29 days. We're literally, like, a stream away. We have so much to catch up on. But I celebrated my first Christmas with my friends this year. It was very fun. Christmas is kind of crazy. For those of you who don't know, I'm Jewish. Shalom. How was everyone's Hanukkah for those who celebrate? I hope it was great. I got a suitcase. I'm very excited about my suitcase. 300 Luna. Yes. Aw, Kalia, you better stop. I have so many thoughts because I haven't been here in so long. I'm going to try to stream as much as I can before New Year's. So close to 30, you can do it. I'm trying so hard to, like, I want to stream for, like, 5 minutes. And that way... Ryzen. Merry Quibbus. Thank you. Bye. Thank you. If she docks herself, I will... Guys, if I've made the decision that if I dox myself and no one notices, it doesn't count. If I dox myself and I play it off and no one fucking calls me out, we good, you know? We're chilling. We're fucking chilling. No one has to know. No one, Chance, I will run an ad just a second. I just did an ad, so give me like a moment. Give me a moment. I just did like a personal ad though. How you doing though? But I'll never publicly call out a dox. Motherfuckers. There was one time where I doxed something so bad. I don't remember what I did. And every person in chat was like, Squid, like, Squid's full name is this. And then, like, there was, like, 300 clips of it. And it took me forever. Yeah, if someone DMs me, I'll count it. But if not, yeah, I've done that. Luna, it's not, like, intentional. I don't wake up in the morning thinking that I'm going to dox myself. It's just, like, it just happens over time. Hi, Girth. Does it count if you don't get caught? Impossible level sneak. I miss Skyrim so much. Wait, I was gonna tell... Okay. I have a thing. I saw the new Black Panther movie. I'm not gonna spoil it. Has anyone seen it? If someone DMs me, your DMs are closed. What are you on about? Well... That's so true. I forgot about that. No, I have. Okay. Bye, Poseidon. Get some sleep. I know it's like 3 a.m. for you. Yes, what you think? I really liked it. The amount of fucking empowerment in that movie, like female empowerment, a slay. Hi, slay. I thought it was really good. I thought it was really good. I have one qualm. I have one qualm. Here's my qualm, okay? Right now, in theaters, Avatar and Black Panther out, okay? And both of the movies have like blue people. So there's probably a little kid somewhere that looked at a commercial and said, "I want to see a movie with like all like with the blue." And then they took them to the wrong movie. And I think that's kind of funny. That's my only, how did the two things get released at the same time? That's my only, like, I was sitting there the entire time. And I was like, there's a fucking little kid that wants to go see Avatar and is gonna see Black Panther. And they watched Megamind. Megamind is the best movie of my generation. I stand by that. Hi, Jack. Doing great in your time off? I'm gonna be honest, my time off was a mix. But the Blue Man said, when I was growing up, I was a drummer. My mom got me into drumming. I did percussion, you know. A lot of people say I give off band kid energy, so if anyone's surprised by that, whatever, okay? You know you're not. I give it off. But there was a period of my life where I was, like, really convinced that I was gonna be, like, the next member of the Blue Man Group. I don't know why I was, like, so convinced, but I was, like, I saw the Blue Man Group somewhere growing up on, like, a trip or something, and I was, like, that's gonna be me, and I got really into it, like, so into the idea of it. I would watch clips of them all of the time. I was obsessed with this idea of, like, I'm gonna be in the Blue Man Group, and I don't know why I ever got rid of that dream, because I still would like to do that. I wanna fucking... They're so cool. They drum and paint comes up, and I want that. That sounds nice. You know, that's like what I do on the internet, but they probably make way more than me. Yeah, it's not too late. You absolutely have drummer ADHD vibes. Is that a good thing? You'd have to go bald. I'm planning on going bald. I'm growing out my hair right now, so I can cut it off and then shave it for charity. Mid-story. Do you want a better story? Have I told you guys a story about how I found out about sex? I was thinking about that story the other day. I don't know, the Shrek movies though, go insane. Buzzcut era. I think I'm gonna look bad, but I think it also might be a slay. Because like, did it? Luna's like, Luna. Oh, add mid story. I thought you were gonna be like, fucking mid story, bitch. And I was gonna be like, okay, no, it's fine. So I took, for those of you who don't know, I took a little bit of a break. The past couple months have been really rough for me. Wallace, thank you for the prime sub, babe. Thank you. But so the past couple months have been like a little like emotional and stuff for me, so I was a little worn out and with school and everything. And at the beginning of the month, I haven't even talked to you guys between this, so I got the flu and I was sick for like 14 days. I was still sick when Hanukkah started 8 days ago. I still had this like cough that I couldn't get over. I couldn't stop coughing. I felt fucking miserable. I was sweating through multiple shirts a day because I was so sick that I would have like 100-something degree fevers and then they would break, and I would just sweat everywhere. Also, Wallace, I do my YouTube stuff. I edit all of my shorts and I go through my VODs and my clips. For those of you that clip, you're so sexy. For people who clip funny moments, you're so sexy. Thank you. We do a good job. Thank you. I do have an editor for some of my full-length videos, but I do everything else. Thank you. And that's not hard work, baby. Well, she's burnt out as fuck, but she's burnt out as fuck. I love your eyeliner. Thank you. But so Good point, Squid. Your health sucks. Yeah, I have autoimmune problems. my body is broken. That is something you'll learn very quickly here. But so, I got really, really ill. And so I was gone for like 14 days. And in that time, for those of you who don't know, I am in my senior year of college. Damn it! Thank you for the 2 months. How you doing? I do it a lot. But I haven't been here in a month, so I'm a little... I haven't even been in front of my PC in like a month. So it's been bad. But... So I'm like very overwhelmed at the moment and trying to think of like all the things I'm trying to say. But so I get super fucking ill, not in front of my PC, whatever. I'm also in my senior year of college. So I am taking classes over my winter break, which means that my 12 week courses were condensed down to 3 weeks. And I was taking two of them at a time, and they barely recommend that you do one, you know? So I start doing this, I get sick, and it's right in my finals week. Jack, thank you for the 10 months. So I am dying in the few hours a day that I'm awake. I'm trying to do my finals, and I'm in a fucking, like, screen acting class, and... I'm like, my professor's asking me to do all these acting exercises, and I can't fucking do them because I don't have a voice and I can't breathe. So that was a whole other thing. I did not do well in that course, but like, it's okay, you know, things happen. But I get very, very ill, and then I was so burnt out from school and everything and trying to edit that my mods forced me to take a little break. And the break was probably really good for my mental health, but I really missed this. It's very nerve-wracking to come back, but my mods yelled at me, shout out my mods, because I also had jury duty. This is an important note. So my classes finished on the 18th. On the 19th, I was supposed to start jury duty. So I was like, no way my entire winter break. And I go back to school like January 3rd. So I was like, no way my fucking entire winter break is gonna be me.
Jury duty story, PLS.
I didn't even end up having to do it, Bethany.
yeah, Squid doesn't listen to her mother. Of course I don't. Jury duty is like a thing in the US that you have to like serve on a jury in a court. Don't students get jury duty? Yeah, no. So basically, I was summoned this summer, and I was like, hey, besties, I'm a student. The only time I could do this is if you called me on like the 2 weeks of my winter break. And so they did. They did it. Because you can't get out of it. You can just delay. But the most you can delay is 6 months. So they did it during my winter break for fucking Hanukkah and Christmas. Because Hanukkah and Christmas were in the same fucking week. They didn't give a fuck. And I was so upset about it. I cried about it multiple times. The amount, bitch, I gotta fit check. I'm so sorry, Lord. I'm so sorry. Lord, I'm sorry. I have a lot of thoughts going on right now. Thank you, Chai, for the tier one, by the way. I'm wearing my merch that's dropping January 2nd and jeans and socks and a Jewish necklace I have. What a power move. I know. 10 out of 10 merch. Do we like it? Multiple people miscast. Bro. I've never received jury duty. I was shocked that I did. Everyone told me if you delay, like, they never summon you. And then they did. And I cried so much. I was so upset. I was so upset that I was gonna not have a fucking winter break. And then, you know, you find out like a day or two before if you're needed. And I wasn't. What college do you go to? It's a secret. I can't tell you. I'm trying really hard not to dox myself, but I go to a school and it's really sucky. I don't know, college to me, like, I'm not walking for my, like, I'm graduating early. I'm not walking to get my degree. I don't really see a point. University of your mom. New stream, are you on drugs? Nope, this is just me. I wish I was on drugs. I don't. Don't do drugs, kids. That's a joke. Buggy!
It's been over a year with Squid and I loved every day of it. Now it's been 5 months since my subs started. I love you, Squid. You're also a Rizzler. Squid, Squid Ink, Riz, 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 Squid Ink, Riz.
Thank you for the 5 months, Buggy. I appreciate you.
Just act mentally insane. They won't make you... No, guys, I'm not gonna fucking do... I'm not gonna fucking do it. I'm not gonna do drugs. You're cocaine hyped. I don't do drugs. I don't do drugs. I have enough brain damage as it is. I don't need more drugs. But I do smoke weed on occasion. But other than that, I do not do drugs. ADHD. Yeah, I just have ADHD, guys. I just have ADHD. But walk was cathartic for me. But I graduated in the middle of the pandemic. Yeah, see, so I have been online for almost all of my schooling, and I don't really have any attachment to my university. So for me, I'm like, what's the point of walking? I'd rather maybe have, like I'm going to do a graduation subathon. So wait, what did Kat say? It's good. Why'd you give me VIP? Me VIP and Zoom me. I'm literally... Wait. What?
Listen, I found you on YouTube and I am literally in awe by you and you're so pretty. Help me, so no thank you for blessing me with your gorgeous face. V, I hope you're having a great evening. Less than three. Thekart gifted a tier 1 sub to Zoomies. This is their first gift sub in the channel.
Chai, thank you for the 10 bucks and for calling me pretty. I really needed that today. Thank you. And Kat, thank you for the gifted sub. Cameroon, hello. Zumi got rejected. I did reject Zumi, actually. Zumi, can I talk about this? I didn't know. I pulled a Jade. I didn't know Zumi was for real. I didn't know Zumi was trying to slide, but now I'm like emotionally invested, you know? It's still in Jade. I didn't mean to, Zumi. I'm sorry. I love you. You're a 10 out of 10. But that's exactly why I can't, you know? You're out of my league. Yeah, anyway, gamers. So, Puggies. Zumi, do you want VIP? Guys, my parents don't even have VIP. Sarah. Oh, no, Sarah does. I'll remove Sarah's. Squid has become the very... Okay, no. So, here's the thing. Here's what happened. He's a 10, but he subs to Squid Ink and Ink. He's an 11. I've been friend-zoned so hard. Fuck! I don't... Shit, bro. This is so awkward now. And my least favorite song came on this playlist. Oh my god. Okay. Here's the thing. Zumi, I love you, Shadi. I had no idea you were for serious. I had no idea you... Do you want VIP? Shit. Oh my god, Flamingo, help me. Let's go to his bag. Yeah, I'm 6 foot. Pole that rejected me. Did I really? No. But like, you weren't for serious. Okay, it's good. Squid's worse with women. It's cause women are scary. It's okay. Wait. Sumi, I love you. Wait, Sumi. Oh my god. Wait, I'm so this is so scary. Is this how Jade felt? No, but like, okay, actually, I found out the Jade situation is so much worse than I thought it was. For those of you who don't know, I have a YouTube video on it. Squid pulled Jade. I did not pull Jade. I have a YouTube video on it. It's really funny. I highly recommend watching it. I'll put the link in chat real quick. But, hold up, where is it? So, My one of my so I have some I have a couple real close gal pals. One of them is Jade. And here's the link to this video if you want the background information. But oh my god, Ben, thank you for the 2 months.
Have a great stream.
Thank you. I feel like have a great stream means that you are going out. So good night, my friend. But so basically, I was into Jade for a very long time. Jade had no clue and rejected me. Recently, Jade and I were talking about how much I liked her and stuff. And I found texts of me messaging Jade and saying, I want to take you on a date. And Jade saying, I would love to. And talking about how great our date was going to be. And she wonders why I felt like there were mixed signals. I have legitimate proof of this. I'm going to kiss the homies. I'm homies, bro. Thank you. Thank you, Kylo. Classic Jade. Classic Jade. No, but like that is the worst part is that I openly asked her. I will find the DMs. I openly asked Jade. Jade is not available right now. Jade just texted me. Oh, fuck. What did I do? Oh, no. My Nana said that I'm beautiful. Hi, Nana. I love you. Found you getting mixed messages. You know what? It happens. It's spread about the same person every time. Anyway. Okay, someone, Maverick, first off, welcome on into the stream. Second off, I watched Top Gun for the first time. I am very invested in movies. Am I gonna get a kiss from the homies? Well, at least you have some Riz. I don't have any Riz. But that's okay. My New Year's goal is to get Riz. We watched Bullet Train. Bullet Train is so good. The new one, I watched the new one. I've never seen the first one. But when we go drinking, Zumi, we're going to have a night when you come and visit me. Also, remind me to change this to 29 in a minute. But
hello, just a reminder, you look amazing today and every day. Thank you for being you.
Thank you, Crafts. Thank you. Welcome on in today. Versus Charisma, and you're maxed out on Charisma. I think here's the thing. Violet, I've been wanting to watch Violet Night. Wait, someone asked what type of movies I like. I like everything. There's not a specific type of movie I like. I like everything. I'm not a picky person with movies. If it's entertaining, I'm gonna like it. I like action movies. I like dramas. I like comedies. I like rom-coms. I love to watch rom-coms when I feel lonely because then I get to feel worse about my life. Like, so part of me is really happy that I've never been in like a happy relationship because now rom-coms have such a good effect, you know, because I get to be sad. And like when he like comes to her window and he's like, I love you, bitch. I'm like, no guy's ever gonna feel the way. It's great. I love it. Human Centipede. I've never seen it because I hate bugs. But I have seen Hereditary. And I think horror movies are just comedies, but nobody, you just gotta think about it correctly, you know? Like, every movie's a comedy if you think about it, right? Life is a little goofy gaff, you know? I love you, bitch. Doesn't have bugs in it, but there's a centipede. It's a human centipede. Also, thank you for all the gay flags. Hi, Storm Goat.
Hi, Squiddy. Missed you parasocially.
Hello, welcome back. How you doing? With a boombox, have you guys ever done a romantic gesture? Like, has anyone in chat ever done, like, a real, like, romantic gesture? I don't think it's real. Yes? What have you done? That's not what a centipede... Well, it's because their heads are, like, in... Many times? Constantly? You've made so many people fall in love with you. Hello there. Sorry, I read that like it's... Opinion on streamer Squid Ink and Ink? Fucking unfunny, bitch. Do flowers count? I love flowers. I hate flowers, but I love them. I think plants as a gift are stupid. Oh, Duel, I'm so sorry. Girlfriend at the timer. See, that's so cute. But like, have you ever like won someone back? Have you ever won someone back, you know? With this pull, have you ever, like been into someone and you weren't sure how they felt, so you showed up with this, like, elaborate plan, and you were like, I love you. Has anyone done that? Because I want to know. Because, like, I've done cute things for a partner, you know? They've never done them back, but I've done cute things for a partner before. I'm a huge hopeless romantic. Flowers came to a really beautiful restaurant. We danced with all the old people. Mm-hmm. Oh, wait, that's so cute. That sounds like a movie fantasy, but, like, yeah, I don't know. But, like, some people say that they have. This can... Sorry. Okay, slay. I never lost anyone. Oh, wait. Never loved anyone to try and win them back. Okay, Barbosa, that's a...
Squid. Less than 3.
Hi, Aiden. Hi. Thank you for the 6 months. Also, next charity stream, probably February. I think for last year for Valentine's Day, I took Chad on a date. I think we're going to do something like that again this year and maybe make it a charity stream. If you guys are down, I think that's the next thing we're going to do, and it's going to be a full plan. But bye, musician. Text place with Flowers after breaking up with her. Okay. Flowers, I think Flowers are so sweet, but here's my thoughts on it. Flowers are super cute. Like, I understand flowers in relationships, but, like, my parents growing up, whenever we would go to, like, people's houses for dinner or something, a lot of times my parents would bring, like, a plant. If I invite you to my house for dinner or something, do not bring me a fucking plant. I don't want... Why would you bring me something else to take care of? Like, that to me is so fucking stupid. It's so stupid. Why would you do that? Like, why? You know? Because gifting a commitment. Exactly. Like, thank you for doing a bunch of work. And, like, because these people, like, are setting up their home. They're probably cleaning their home before you come over. They are cooking all this food or whatever. You might bring something, but they're cooking all the food. And then they're going to clean up from it. And they're hosting. And they're going to, like, take your jackets or whatever the fuck. I'm drinking water. Don't bring me another fucking... thing to take care of. And people, I'm sorry, if someone got me an animal, like, you know when, like, couples surprise each other and they're like, here is a dog that you've been wanting, I don't give a fuck. Don't surprise me with an animal, especially at weddings. Don't fucking do that. I think that shit's bullshit. I'm sorry if you disagree. I'm really sorry if you disagree. But when people gift each other animals at your wedding, it is so stupid to me. You are already committing to a marriage right that day. And now you want a fucking animal now? Give it a time. Give it time. People gift each other dogs at weddings, and I think it's stupid. Like, can you boost my, I will boost it. Like, there have been people where, like, the bride has given the groom a dog because he wants a dog. And I think that's amazing. Go get a dog together. But do not gift me an animal. Do not gift me an animal. I don't give a fuck if I wanted it. I don't give a fuck if I wanted an animal. I don't want that. I want to go with you to the shelter, and I want to pick it out when I am ready. I do not want to be shocked with a commitment. Absolutely not. I want to be completely prepared for it. And maybe I'm just a woman of preparation. But do not gift me anything that involves me taking care of it. You know what is a nice gift? Something that I don't have to take care of. That would be very nice. Take this creature. Take a fucking plant that you're gonna have to water. I kill all my fucking plants. Not because I want to, but because I'm incompetent. Because I can barely take care of myself, and I cannot take care of a fucking plant. I have really strong feelings about this. I get so, you know that I'm angry when my voice does this. When I get in this, like, fuck this shit. Like, why do I do that? Thank you. Brother, you're so sweet. Thank you. Welcome on in. I really appreciate that. Like, I've been seeing all your nice messages. Don't be incompetent. Drink water. What if I talk like this the rest of the stream? I sound like the gingerbread man from Shrek. What kind of attachment? I have a secure attachment style. Thank you. Wait, you're... Mickey Mouse here. Not the gumdrop. Not the gumdrop buttons. The Muffin Man. It's kind of... You sound like you have anxiety. Yeah, and... Yeah, I have anxiety. What about it? Why is that relevant? Like in a relationship? Here's my thing about relationships and why I have a secure attachment style, okay? I've been cheated on before. I've had a fair amount of bad partners for my age. And, you know, like, if someone is going to cheat on me, or if someone's going to not treat me well, whatever, that sucks. Great, then I'm one step closer to finding the person I want. If someone does not want to be with me, that is fine. That is fine. That's cool. If you don't want to be with me, great, that's fine. I will find the person who does want to be with me. You know, if I'm in a relationship and they cheat on me, or I feel like they are pulling away, or like, not I feel like they're pulling away, because I'm really like, you know, I've been in relationships where, like, you know, they just moved on, and that's okay. Like, it sucks, it hurts, it's never not gonna hurt, but if you don't want to be with me, then don't be with me. That is absolutely fine, because I'm fucking great. You know, and I think that there's a lot of, something that I saw today is one of the reasons that I used to have a very anxiety-based attachment style. And it's always because I thought that I wasn't beautiful on the inside or the outside. And something that, I saw this today, like, recently, and it is that, like, which is a very fucked way of looking at it, but it was like the Kardashians are some of the most beautiful, like, society has defined them as some of the most beautiful women on the planet, okay? They work out, they take care of themselves, they have amazing skincare, they're wearing all this incredible clothing, they're incredibly successful. They are what society has idolized as beautiful, okay? And people, this is fucked, people still cheat on them, because it's not about that. If someone wants to be with you, they're gonna be with you. If someone doesn't, they won't. And that is how it is at the end of the day. So all that you need to focus on is being you and being the best partner you can be. And if that is not the right person for you, then it's not the right person for you. And if you cheat on someone, fuck you. Don't cheat on someone. Don't cheat. If you are not interested in someone anymore, then end the relationship. Period. But I will not sit there and get hung up on an idea that someone might potentially cheat on me one day. Because if they do, all that I've learned is that they're not my person, and that's fine. Don't forgive someone for cheating is my personal opinion, but I've never cheated. No. No. I am loyal to a fault, baby. When I say, like, holy fuck, this is a person... Holy fuck. that's so sweet. Thank you. I would like to think I'm pretty funny, you know? That's like kind of my main thing in life. Got you. That's how I feel about it. I'm loyal to a fault. I'm hard loyal to a fault. Which is something else I've worked on. I've talked about this a lot on stream before, of like, I'm very bad at recognizing, fuck your ex, bro. But I'm really bad at recognizing red flags. Really bad at it. But I've gotten a lot better in the past couple years. But I'm loyal to a fault. But yeah. Guys, don't Tarkov red flag. Fuck off. Don't even start me on that. Also, CEO, hello. I am dehydrated, but I just drank. I'm even worse at recognizing when I'm the red flag. Imagine you're a streamer, but you can't reach out. What do you mean? I can recognize this one. Ha 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 ha. Yeah, I never cheat either. I've never been in a relationship.
Well, yeah, no, cheating to me is stupid. I've never understood that. But I have, I don't know. Like, I've openly, there's one relationship, there's one person I dated. I really talk with them. It was a very short relationship, but we weren't compatible. And I just wasn't, like, I found myself in the relationship after, like, a month or two, just kind of being like, this person's really nice. I have nothing wrong with them. There's nothing wrong with them. They treat me really well. They're probably, like, one of the nicest people that I've dated. But I just wasn't, wasn't the person for me. And I was never going to cheat on him, but I just had an open conversation with him of like, hey, you're really cool. I would really like to be friends, but I think that, like, I just don't think this is that I am. I was just kind of like sad, but I was like, I really don't think that I want to continue this anymore. I think you're a great guy, but I just don't think I'm continuing that attraction in the same way that I had at first. And he agreed and we moved forward. Sorry, he was just boring. No, he wasn't boring. He's a very funny person. But he just wasn't what I want in a partner. And that's cool. Totally fine. And we both moved forward. He is a girlfriend now. Slay. You know? Like, it's... You said those are friends on merch? Still cool with him? Yeah. I'm cool with a few of my exes. Communication is key, bro. As long as... I don't know. I just, like, reverse Riz. Yeah, I'm cool with my exes. Some of them. There's two that I'm not. Once a cheater, always a cheater. I can't speak on that. Because I've dated one person who has cheated on me. But, yeah. Also, I actually do want to talk about something because I want to get your guys' opinion on it. This is a little political for me. I'm kind of chill tonight because I think I'm a little overwhelmed by everything. But, so I don't like the mentality of like men suck, fuck men. I think what is better is kind of fuck societal norms or fuck patriarchy. Because I think saying fuck to an entire, like, group of people or gender identification is kind of bullshit. I don't think people are inherently bad. I don't think being assigned male at birth is something that makes you a bad person. And I don't like that, this kind of mentality of like, fuck men. I think that there have been things that have been like instilled in society through the patriarchy that have led to some of the things that we lead to this like conclusion of fuck men. Also, Crazy Talk, thank you so much for the prime. Leads to so much transphobia too. Yeah. Men as a group of people are not the problem. A patriarchy is the problem. Toxic masculinity is the problem. But you cannot put that on a gender. That's bullshit. In my opinion. Thank you so much, Storm Goat, for the 3 gifted subs. Sorry, I'm like a little... Like, they have y'all to go, thank you. Sorry, I'm having like a serious conversation at the moment. How are you doing? Thank you so much for the gifted subs. Yeah, no, I don't, like, my sister, like, very recently was like, fuck men. Men, all men suck. And I was like, that is not true. A lot of people suck. But, you know, okay, I'll kind of reiterate what I said. But basically what I said is that the mentality of fuck men is a bad mentality. Rather, it should be fuck the men, like, fuck the mentality, fuck the patriarchy, fuck, like, stereotypical gender roles, fuck, I'm forgetting my word, toxic masculinity. Those are the things that we should be saying fuck to. We should be saying fuck off to that. But That is what I stand by. Also, CEO, what accent would you like? Oh God, this is okay. But that is something, and I think that a lot of people, when they say a southern accent, oh God, wait, hold up, I don't know if I can do a southern accent quite well. Wait, like, hold up, I gotta take these off for that. CEO, what kind of French accent? Okay, hold up, I can sort of do a French accent, I think. I have some. Hold up, it takes me a minute. Ah oui, oui, mon ami, je m'appelle Lafayette. Hold up. Your southern was my French. Really? I was slaying French the other day. Hold up. I get nervous doing it. Bonjour. Bonjour. Pog, pog, pog. Your ears are shit. Okay. French accent. Snackly. I'm so nervous doing French. I haven't done French on stream ever. Woohoo! Thank you for the aid. Thank you for the gifted subs. Oh my God. Okay, wait. I can do this. CEO redeemed this. I can do this. I like your hat. I'm going British now. French accent, oui. Je parle un petit peu au français parce que mes grand-mères origines sont français. Oui. Okay. I can tell you it's late if you got into a good rhythm. It's hard to get into a good rhythm while I stream because I want to be energetic and my French accent is not very energetic. I don't know how to... Hello. I can't... Oh my God, you CEO, you little bastard. I can't do the French accent right now. The French is really good. Thank you. Okay. Whew. It's also hard because I'm in a mentality... Okay. French. CPH, me men got used to the fuck men thing. What can you do? I think that do a southern accent now. I think my southern accent might be a little bit better today because I think my southern accent is a little faster for me and it requires less thought. But southern accent, So my French accent isn't coming out too naturally today, which is all right. Vous voulez coucher avec moi ce soir? Stop using chat to dodge the front. Okay. Okay. But I think that a lot of people who say that they say fuck men don't actually mean fuck men. But they say it not knowing what they mean. French accent goes out. Thank you. Does it? Is it okay? Well, my family's like all French. Is my French accent okay? It's like I have a weird like phlegm in the back of my throat when I say French. It's merci. I get nervous doing accents a little bit, but unrelated squid. Thank you, cat. Thank you, merci. Sound like my therapist if I went to therapy, which I'm getting British. Ooh, but okay, hold up. Let me finish my point. So, hold up. I'll go back to the accent just a moment. But I'd just like to say that I am no longer in theater at my university. I used to be. I transferred out of it because of the pandemic, but I do miss it. But I think a lot of people say fuck men and they don't mean that. I think that it is kind of a sentence that we have coined. And I don't think that's what a lot of people mean. Because when I said this to a couple of my friends, they were all like, that's what I mean. But, you know, it's just on a playlist. I have no idea what's playing right now, actually. I can't even hear it. But, you know... That is, it comes out a lot of frustration, and I get that. But I think we need to be careful in the way that we word it, you know? The easiest way I looked at it was to speak with the roof of your mouth. Well, that's what's so cool about accents, is, like, where we hold, like, French being higher and, like, in the front of, like, I feel like front of your mouth, and then, yeah, the roof, and then, like, when I speak normally, it's more in, like, the back of my throat, like, you know? I get what you're saying. Does that make sense? Pee-pee or poo-poo? Does that make sense, though? Am I making sense? Do we agree with that, like, analysis? That is... I was willingly kind of political for a second. Look at me. I'm not a very political streamer. Yeah, we were just talking about like the patriarchy. Please, do you guys mind when I'm political? I'm not a very political person. But also, I'm surprisingly chill today, it's kind of nice. I think I needed a chill little comeback, you know?
Thanks for being cool. I don't think I've heard someone say that being a cis guy is okay in quite a while. All opinions are valid, but I don't like getting knocked down cause other people of my gender have been bad. And yes, you're making sense.
Thank you for the tip, Davin. Nice. Oh my god. Good. Thank you. Thank you. thank you so much. Oh, holy fuck. It's a lot of money. Thank you. Lit, thank you for the 5 months as well. Oh my god. I'm doing all right. Hold up. Thank you so much, Davin. Yeah, I don't want to hate on any, like, I'm not gonna hate on someone. Sorry, hold up. A lot of men write it off as claim concepts. No such thing as speech. Once we said fuck men, our men ain't shit. Hold up. And I should criticizing patriarchy. A lot of them write it off and claim that the concept. Yes! 100%. 100%. 100%. I do 100% agree with what you're saying. I don't wanna like write that off of that it's been like fucked, like disagreeing about like the patriarchy has been kind of like written off as nothing. But I just like I said that in a sense of I don't want to hold up. I need to format my words correctly with this. Some people are cool, some people are shit. Yeah. Yeah. I think just saying fuck a whole group of people can be very toxic, but I think that there wasn't recognition about the problem until that happened. I totally agree with that. What, and like, I don't want to write that off, if that makes sense. Am I making sense right now? I feel like I don't make sense. Fuck a whole group of yeah. They're streaming. How you eat some acorns? Bye. Don't. I get what you're saying. I have a hard time. I'm kind of like waiting for Kat's answer. Yeah, I'm not great at explaining my thoughts a lot of the time. That's something I've already explained, so I've kind of like done it a couple times. Because I don't want to sound like I'm disregarding that. I don't want to muted. I don't strongly identify with masculinity, so because I don't want to sit here and I don't want to be like encourage toxic toxic masculinity and stuff. I don't want to seem like I'm encouraged that. No, Kat, you know, you're making a valid point. That's no. I'm it's hard to have a debate on these things when I'm kind of like, you know. If I've said something that's coming off of like I support toxic masculinity or that kind of stuff, I don't wanna come across that way. Because that's not what I mean at all. And if that's the way that I'm coming off, please let me know. I will credit about experience. Okay.
Sorry about the unexpected bits, but I had some to spare and I am sending some
Thank
your
you,
way.
Stargazer. I just think it's important to understand the context. Oh, yes, okay. Okay. Yes. I'm glad you brought in the context. Thank you. Thank you. That is important. That is important. I think it needed to happen. Okay. Okay. We're all agreeing. I just get nervous. Thank you. Also, I need to change my board to 29 days. So can we get some poggies in chat? Thought we hit 30 already? No, we did not. We are at 29 streams, which means next stream we hit 30 and the board goes away. I don't know where the fuck my eraser is. Is today 30? No, today's 29. We're one away. We're one stream away. Next stream, we will have hit 30 and the board can go away. I don't know where my purple marker is, so this is gonna be blue, baby. 29 motherfucking streams without me doxing myself. 29, baby. That's a good start. We were for a moment. But I'm gonna change because I feel like I am getting nervous. Talking about politics on the internet is something that is very scary for me. And I will admit right now, part of that is because I am not a person who is very informed on a lot of politics. And I will openly admit that kind of bias. And whenever I'm uninformed and I talk about something, I will openly say that I am uninformed. And I will just say my opinion based on what I know. But, and if I have information that is missing, I am glad to be informed when I'm talking about those topics. But, talking about politics is something that is not really my domain. And it's because, it's because I'm uninformed. It's something that makes me really anxious. And it can cause a lot of tensions, you know? That's just something, it just makes me anxious sometimes. Flamenco, thank you so much for the bits. I appreciate it. I don't know. It's scary. Because all I wanna, here's why I think it's scary. I always, when you are uninformed, that's the best way I think to say it. When you are uninformed, you could say something that you don't necessarily mean, but it's because you're uninformed and you make an assumption. And being someone who is politically uninformed quite frequently, I like to understand what I'm saying before I say my opinion. So I'm not apolitical. I have opinions. I am uninformed
as well. As far as I go about politics, and I probably mentioned this before, I don't get involved with politics for two reasons. One, it's nothing but a splitting G headache. Two, no matter what side you are on, it's a no-win scenario every time. Like Newt Scamander once said, I don't do sides.
Okay. Okay. Understandable. You underestimate your uninformedness? Okay. Maybe. I don't know. I think I see myself as, like, very uninformed and stuff. I think I've gotten more informed recently with things because I have friends who have been talking about it with me. But I always talk about my bias with stuff. That's always kind of been my thing. Also, no, I am not. I think it's because I'm in my serious mode. Yeah, is ask questions. 100%. And I only, like, I'm a person who just wants to spread love and happiness. But, you know, it's, yeah.
I just get nervous. I just get nervous, you know?
And so, like, yeah. It's also, like, politics can be, like, heavy and serious. And sometimes streaming for me is an escape from the heavy and serious. Even though lately I feel like it's been an escape, but I think I've also been talking about heavier topics recently. Which, for those of you who are coming from YouTube and see me very curated and see, like, the funniest moments, my stream isn't that. There's a lot of funny moments, but some days are more like today where we're just kind of chilling and talking about stuff. Yeah. That is slight squib head just not working. Is it not? This is a girl that lies to her Uber drivers. Okay, Lord, I know what you're trying to do. Squid should never have jokes. Squid not my biggest. Oh my god, I've forever asked if I had fucking anxiety earlier. Yes, I have anxiety. Anytime I have a serious conversation on stream, I'm like, they're not gonna think I'm funny anymore. You lie to any Uber drivers recently? My friend and I were out to dinner and I told them it was our like anniversary. My friend told me that it was that like because we had a reservation because we were celebrating something. But just some like recent good news that has happened, but that's none your beeswax because it's not my right to share it. So but we were out to dinner. Why are you holding? Oh, it's just it was on my desk and I needed to play with something. I can't find my little thingy. I have a little thingy I play with, but I don't know where I put it, so I'm playing with singles. It's like what? Like I think like $20-something. It's not that much. But showing that cat. No. It's like this is like all of the cash that I have. I'm not a cash person. Cash, I don't ever use cash. But it does make me feel kind of cool. But we were out to dinner and they told me that they were like, I told them it's our wedding anniversary. And I was like, we're simply not married. And they're like, yeah, but it'll be funny. And then they didn't actually do that. And I was really disappointed about it. Because I was ready to lie about it. When people come up to me on the streets and they're like, because you know how people like talk about stuff on the street. This is such a weird thing. How do I word this? Like, there's people that are out for like a cause or something and they try to get you to like donate to the cause or like go to their website or something, or you know, they're like advertising on the street, whatever. Panhandlers, but also sign a petition. The sign a petition, yes. They want you to sign a petition and shit. So one time they like when they try to talk to me, I also lie about my life sometimes. Cause like there was one guy that was like, what are you? Like fresh out of high school? And I was like, I'm 27. I'm married and I have 3 kids. And he was like, oh, slay. You know? Like that, you know, I like doing that. Like that's funny to me. You know? Well, it's not like funny, it's just like a moment. Like, he's never gonna see me again. And I signed his fucking petition. Sam, you look fit for 3 kids. I saw a MILF the other day, bro. I saw a fucking MILF the other day. How old are you? I'm 21. Squid lives for the bit. I have a friend who, like, I go far for the bit. I have never met someone who goes as far as this man goes for the fucking bit. He has, like, while I was on my break, he was like, oh, Squid's not streaming right now, so it's my turn to be a pro streamer. And he spent hours in, like, After Effects creating transitions and making the most professional-looking fucking stream I've, like, ever seen in my life. Just for him to stream 2 times while I was gone, and then he's done streaming now because I'm back. Hello, frail woman. Am I okay? Thank you. Hi, welcome on in. She verbatim said, ooh, slay. Yeah. My dad says slay now. It makes me so happy. We have in my family, we have a thing that we do, and it's Summer Party Fashion Show. And it's whenever you get new clothing, I play RuPaul's Drag Race music, and you like strut your stuff, and we're like, work, slay, mama boots, you know? It's great. I think Squid IRL, I would love to do IRL content once I announce where I live, because right now y'all don't know, and if I leave my home, you're gonna know. But would you guys want a like day in the life of a full-time coomer, part-time streamer, part-time student, full-time coomer? I wish my dad was half as, I mean, he has 3 daughters, you know? My dad is very comfortable with that shit now, and it's very awesome. I love my parents. So fun. I can't. Ah! Goy! Thank you for the 3 months, Goyle. How you doing? Also, Manuel, I love the color you chose for your username. That pink is very pretty on my mom.
Hello, motherfucker.
How you doing, Koi? What happens to the French squid? I have to pee.
do a day in the life video. Easy to cut out doc stuff.
True, but I, yeah, probably. Oh, wait, punch. Oui.
Oui, oui. It's just the pink of your background. I know, I like the color pink. I didn't used to like the color pink. Growing up, I hated the color pink. Okay, hold up. I'm sorry, I did the French for a few minutes. Do I have to keep going? Do you want me to keep going? Because I can if you want. Can you do a chamber? What's a chamber voice line? Give me a chamber voice line. When I was growing up, when I was really little, I loved pink. I loved pink. But then I had a lot of guy friends, and my guy friends were like, "Pink's not a cool color." Well, no, their voices hadn't dropped yet. We were in like kindergarten. "Pink's not a cool color," and I was like, "It's the best color." And they were like, "No, it's not. It's lame." And I was like, "Fuck!" Like, these guys think that pink's a lame color. And they're my friends, so I gotta change it. So I started writing. I started liking the color red because red was the color of blood. That's literally the reason I gave people. I was like, "Red's the color of blood. I'm edgy as fuck, bro." And when people ask me, every single time it'd be like, "What's your favorite color?" And I'd be like, "Red, because it's a color of blood." Because I was like, I wanted to be like cool. I wanted to be cool, and I do love red. It's one of my favorite colors. But I was like, you know, I'm tired. I'm sorry. I just recently started liking pink again. I didn't used to like pink. I thought it looked weird. I mean, light pinks, not my vibe. I think they're pretty, not my vibe. Darkness, my old friend.
I've come to talk with you again.
Thank you. I know. It's hello dark. I started watching Wednesday today. I'm halfway through the first episode. I have thoughts already. So far, the thing that I have taken, it almost was the title of today's stream. I have one comment, and that is blonde roommate, Enid, whatever the fuck her name is. One of her first lines is like, "Then why did you go to normie school?" And that ruined it for me. It also made it 100 times better. But like, hearing the word normie on a television show just kind of like fucked me up, you know? Like, I was sitting there and I was like, do you guys know what I'm talking about? She says, like, "Why did you go to normie school?" Did you call everyone normies? But they don't even mean it in a gamer way. Like, it's literally, they're just like, "Fucking normies." What? I am not a normie. The day normie time. What's the problem? No, I don't be a normie if you want. But I just, like, it's like, that's like an internet word. Like, imagine if you're watching fucking, the mainstream's appropriating our fucking gamer words. Like, imagine if you're watching Wednesday, okay? And like, you know, she does her little, like, Kubrick stare to the camera or whatever the fuck. And she's like, "It's so poggy woggies when I bully Pugsley." Like, that's not okay. That's not cool. That's my thing. Like, I don't understand. she does not say poggers. Don't mess with me like that. Oh, I have to run an ad. I also really have to piss. OMG Wednesday, you look so poggy woggies today. Okay, hold up. Let me run an ad. Okay. I'm gonna pee during this ad, by the way. All right. I'm a little peepo nervous right now to run this peepo ad, but that's okay because sometimes I'm just like a peepo silly Billy, you know, but
It's Peepo shy time. It's Peepo ad time. So we're going to Peepo run a little Peepo ad. My Peepo mods are going to do it. Well, I go Peepo piss. So I'm going to go Peepo piss. And you're going to watch a Peepo ad. And I'm really sorry about that Peepo ad. But how you can get rid of the Peepo ad while I Peepo piss is if you Peepo subscribe to the channel. And you can Peepo prime sub. Or you can just Peepo normal sub. One costs money, one doesn't though. Or if you're feeling really generous, you can Peepo gift subs. can we make Peepo prime sub a command? sorry. I Peepo giggle champed. So I'm gonna go piss. I'm gonna Peepo grab Plinky. And see you on the other side. Okay. TMI. I'm going to pee. It's not a big deal. It's funny. That wasn't a giggle, it was a screech. It happens. Whoa, total vibe shift. Prodigy, this is the most I've seen you talk in my chat in a while, and it's making me really happy right now. I'll be back. Hi. Did you miss me? Say you missed me. Are we talking about how my apartment's haunted? Missed you? Aw. Thank you. Thank you. I really need to hear that, honestly. Oh my god, the music! Oh, it's so loud! Cold, guys. Thank you for the sub, monkey. Davin, thank you for the $5, baby. Thank you for the five. Hey there, buddy. What you doing? Mooney there, what you doing, bud? Why did you change your Twitch profile photo? What you doing there, bud? What you doing there? Mooney, you didn't need to do that. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate you. Why are you doing that, bud? Why are you doing that? Why you do that, bud? Squid pretty? Squid fucking tired. Squid fucking tired at the moment, actually. This is a very chill stream for me. I feel so weird. Month number five, babes! Mooney, thank you for the 10 gifted. Thank you.
Beans.
What the hell?
Yeah, no, I got there. Yeah, yeah. I just looked at your name and I was about to say butt sex.
And I don't know why. But I was like, butt sex, thanks for the 5 months. And that's not what it was. As Maddie Kid, thank you for the tier one. How are you doing? Oh, fuck. Okay. Hold up. I need a second, chat. I need a fucking second. Hi from YouTube. Welcome. That's worse than the original. I'm sorry. I don't know what's going on with me. I think I'm dying right now. Oh, I should call her. Gosh. Fuck up. Come over to a party, hang out. She said she was busy, but I changed the date and she hasn't responded yet. I'm sorry. Super spicy, thank you for the 2 months. Sorry. I'm so overwhelmed. Oh my god. I just got so overwhelmed. I'm really sorry, Spartan. Maybe you could, maybe we find better. Cause like that doesn't sound too foggy. Y'all right? Yeah, I'm good. Just give me a second. I think I got overwhelmed by the stimuli of me peeing. I don't know what the fuck just happened. For my neurodivergent people, have you ever just like yes, this is stream 29. Have you ever just been sitting there and suddenly you get like really overwhelmed? Am I having a panic attack? Am I having an anxiety attack from streaming? No. I don't know, but like I peed. I think what happened is I went into a room where there wasn't a lot of stimuli, and then I came back to a room with like a fuck ton of stimuli, and I put the headphones on and I was like, ew? It happens, and hey, first stream back, that's true. This is like my first stream in a month, basically. Your nails are great. Thank you. I got them done. I've missed having my nails done. Me at parties sometimes, I hate getting overstimulated. I got overstimulated so bad in a bar and I felt so bad. How was jury duty? I didn't end up having to do it, but the idea of it made me cry. I got super overstimulated in a bar once and I was crying and my friend had to take me home. I felt so bad. Your hair's top notch. I got a haircut. My hair's been kind of struggling lately. You know, like it's just not as curly as it was. I'm trying to get it back. I really just want to shave my head, but no one will let me. I go to get my haircut before Christmas and I tell my stylist, I was like, I want to shave my head. And the guy that was in the, like doing the person's hair next to me goes, don't you fucking dare shave your head. Cause they were so mad at me that I wanted to like get rid of this. Yeah, I know. But like, also thank you for the tomato. I appreciate it. Thought my reality was breaking. I didn't really start getting overstimulated until after I had my brain injury. I'm gonna shave my head eventually, but like the idea of not having bangs, it's just like, have you guys ever, specifically for those who've had longer hair, do you ever, and especially those who've had bangs, I sometimes just don't want it in my face. Sometimes I just don't want it in my face. Yes, I had a brain injury when I was 16. It's why I'm quirky. I've talked about it a couple times. I need to make a YouTube video on it. It's a long story. But I had a really bad concussion. And it... You know, she's a little quirky now. But yeah, I want to do it. I hate it so much sometimes. Like, we could, like, game or watch videos. Oh, that's why you're quirky. Ha ha. I never want it in my face. Sometimes it just bothers me. But also, like, this is bad. I have a big forehead. I was supposed to do a video that was, like, based on questions. And I asked my, like, on YouTube a bunch of questions. And then I never made the video. We never did. I know we need to do it. There's a bunch of streams that I need to do. Which... I had a bunch of stuff planned and then I decided to take a break, but I'm back. Taking a break is so weird for me though, because not doing stuff is so difficult for me. Like I wasn't editing, I wasn't doing anything. People in my life told me to take an entire break, and that's super difficult for me. That's super difficult for me. I like to constantly be doing stuff. And I think I kind of thrive in being overwhelmed, and not doing stuff makes me kind of sad. Like, this break has definitely been good for me, and I had a lot of very good moments, and I need to learn to take breaks before I hit that edge of, like, dying. But I, like, you know, all I've done is, like, sleep and be with my family. And, like, a couple of my friends. No, you. Yeah, I haven't seen my forehead in, like, 2 years. I know my head. I don't know if my head's especially small, Dredgy. But, you know, I think it's normal size. Having my hands busy. Yeah, no. Doing nothing makes me really sad. It makes me really sad. I'm not a person who can do nothing. Are you rationalizing the concept of resting right now? Are you... Yeah. And what about it? Okay, you know, it's just me being me, bro. Sometimes, maybe. Okay. Hold up an object. Show. This is a mug. I don't think my face is big or small. I think it's just normal. What's the longest you've gone without talking? Like on stream or just in general? Because I've slept for like 27 hours before continuously, other than to get up and pee. So maybe in general, at least a couple days. You know what? Yeah, a couple days. I don't talk in my sleep. I did. Okay. Also, how did a couple days? Yeah. Yeah. When there was a time during COVID where I didn't speak for so long that I when I talked for the first time, I was like, what the fuck? Yes, I do have a Discord. Wait, okay, also, okay, I don't talk in my sleep, but I don't know how no one figured out that I was gay based on how I sleep, because I went to nature camp. My parents forced me to go to nature camp, and there was a girl who, when I think about it, was one of my first crushes, but there was one time we were camping, and the gay sleep is real. No, but like, I'm serious. No, okay, so we're camping and there's four girls in the tent, okay, and I fall asleep, whatever, and I wake up the next morning in her sleeping bag with her. In a sleeping bag. My sleeping bag is empty. I climbed in her sleeping bag. And I don't know. And we woke up at the same time, completely like on top of each other in this sleeping bag. And I don't remember getting in her sleeping bag. She doesn't remember me climbing in her sleeping bag. And so we just moved forward. It was fine. But I sleepwalked into her fucking sleeping bag and we cuddled. No, I can't walk.
to, you know. It was fine. Like, we cuddle as friends later. So it was kind of fine. But, you know. More viz in your sleep? Kind of. As a friend. I had a guy. Oh my god. One of my ex-boyfriends. I had a crush on him for, like, on and off for a long period of time. And I think he knew that. And then one day we're hanging out. We were actually working on something for, like, a class. And we're in, like, his basement working on the project. And we're kind of, like, chilling, you know, taking a break. And he goes, "Have you ever platonically cuddled before?" And I was like, you know, not particularly. And he was like, "It's really great, you should do it sometime." And I was like, yeah. And then a couple seconds later he was like, "You know, we could platonically cuddle."
Rejected. Yeah, you just got rejected. R-E-J-E-C-T-E-D rejected.
I don't know why it's not showing up.
C-T-E-D rejected.
Yes, I then dated this guy, but So he was like, "Yeah, we should platonically cuddle." And I was like, "Yeah." Yeah, it wasn't platonic. Like, nothing crazy happened, but he kissed me when he dropped me home. It was actually kind of sweet, but he was an asshole. Fuck it. You fell for that? I had not been hurt enough to have standards yet. I said, "You're an attractive boy." He played football at one point. And he liked me. And I was like, "Oh, the attention." And then I realized he was a fucking asshole. But, guys, I was like 16. I didn't know better. Okay, I learned from my mistakes. I cuddle the homies. Sarah sleeps over all the time and we cuddle. But I'm so awkward about it. I'd not been hurt enough. Yeah. No, I've talked about this before. I needed to get my heart broken a bunch of times to get standards. And like know my self-worth. You know? I didn't know better. You gotta learn. That's why like was this I don't remember the timeline of that. After. Before? I might have been 15. I might have been 17. It's somewhere. My high school experience is very much a blur for me sometimes. Yeah, Sarah's super cuddly. I'm a mix of like cuddly, because sometimes I'm really cuddly and I want affection, but then other times if you touch me or like come near me, I will be very upset. Because sometimes I just like don't want anyone near me at all, you know, because I'm like, how dare you. But I'll be open about it though. Like, I'm not gonna sit there and I'm gonna be like, no, like I'm not gonna like just sit there and take it and like be upset about it. I'm gonna be like, hey, I don't. It's like, it's a stimuli thing though. It's a like, I'm overwhelmed with stimuli, and if you touch me right now, it's more of like a, I'm gonna freak out. Like, if I'm overwhelmed emotionally, sometimes when I'm overwhelmed emotionally, I want to be held and I want to calm down. And other times, if you hold me, it makes me feel more overwhelmed. Massive cat energy. Meow. Mika, God, what did I give to be Mika's cat so she'd just hold me? Farkin, I'm sorry. Ain't no way she just meowed. I'll end stream. Fuck, okay. I don't know how to do this anymore. Bro, how did I do this? I'm so nervous right now, guys. I'm so nervous. Can you tell that I'm nervous today? I'm so nervous. I woke up from a nap today. And I think that it's thrown off the rest of my day. Am I being weird today? Should I end?
My voice is cracking all over the place today. What is going on? Okay. We're good. Nope. I saw my face. Can't do. Whoa. Woohoo. Hey, gamers. Sorry. I just had to pee real quick. I'm back, though. Someone just had a moment. That was a long piss break. You know me, brain your wall. Woo! I don't know why I'm so nervous today. Get the stim out. I do think I need a stim after this. I'm okay. Is it your first stream? So I've been gone for like a month. And it just like, oh, the chat is gone. Are we good, chat? Are we good? Are you actually, Mika? Are you actually right now? Hold up. I'm going to change to chill music. That might be part of this. Oh, yeah. Eggiest boy, thank you for the sub. Chat. Okay, hold up. Let me put on chill vibes that we'll all like. Yeah? Do we want to? I have a game that we could play, or we could save it for next stream. I was gonna play like High on Life or something, but I think that might be better for another day, because we're already like 2 hours into stream. Are you platonically into cuddling? Yeah, I like to cuddle the homies. Chat just despawned. Everyone in chat right now, give me a 1 out of 10. How was your holidays? Yeah, I think it's way too much stimuli for today. I am a little bit overstimulated. 6, 7, 1. Good year. 3, 5, 0. Okay, well, we're going to have to make that a little better. 6, 9, 7, 8, 10. 6.5. You had fun with your girlfriend. Fuck you for getting pussy. But also, congratulations, bro. That's pretty solid. 5. I'm sorry you've been sick. Feel better. Yeah, we'll do it another day. We'll do it next stream, maybe. This is the first holiday, like the first Hanukkah, Christmas time that I have not cried, but we still have New Year's to go, so that might change. I still haven't given you your gift. I still have to order your gift. I'm really bad about that. I always forget to do that. I'm sorry, Gideon. I'm sorry. There's gonna be a next stream. Of course it's gonna be next stream. I'm back now. We're probably gonna snaggle. With a tier three? Hold up. I gotta give you a sound effect, but my soundboard is gone, so. Thank you. I think I'm gonna stream tomorrow. Let's talk about it.
Let me talk about my schedule.
Let me respond to a DM during stream. I can roll my R's. Okay. I'm probably going to stream tomorrow, 27th. And I'm going to stream 29th. And then maybe a day stream on the 31st. Because originally my stream schedule was Tuesday, Thursday. And I would like to try to get back to that. I would like to try to get back to a stream schedule for you guys. So let's say tomorrow, 7 p.m. CST. Yeah? How's that sound? Tomorrow's 30th. Tomorrow's 30 days. Star, thank you. Thank you for the tier one. How are you doing? I have zero risk, but yeah, okay. Today was the first stream back, and I know I was a little overwhelmed, but I thank you guys for hanging out with me. I haven't been, what's funny is normally when I'm 7 p.m. CST tomorrow, yeah. I'll announce it in the Discord, but are you getting, no, I'm just gonna hang out with a few friends, nothing crazy, probably get drunk, but I don't do that very frequently, so I'm very excited about that.
But good stream time flew by. We don't mind me being a little more low energy. That's okay. We're okay with that. When is community movie night? Let's say Thursday, maybe. Okay, hold up. I'm gonna up. This is low energy. This is me low energy. I've been very overstimulated like this whole stream, and I literally was like, I'm shocked. PB Chan, thank you so much for the tier one. Maybe we do an early stream on Thursday, and then after that, like, we'll do like a fun gaming stream or something, and then maybe a movie in the Discord after. When are your sisters coming back? When they're ready. I actually kind of want to do a mad science stream. I want to start planning some more fun streams. Thank you guys. Like, I spooky. I've been literally just kind of gaming and chilling for a while because of like school and everything and being very burnt out. And I really appreciate you guys being like so cool with that. I'm like actually so nervous. Spooky, do you ever get nervous when you stream? Because you're a sporadic streamer a little bit. Do you ever like come back and get super nervous? Because I've been super nervous and awkward all day today, and I can't figure out why. Let's get cooking, Jesse. No. Yeah, this is me low energy, I think. I can be lower energy, but this is a like majority low energy for me. We love your low key streams. Okay, that makes me happy. I know I ask this a lot. I don't feel anything anymore, Squid. Okay, base relatable content. But, like, if I punched you in the face, you'd fucking feel it, yeah? Like, you're not, like, completely numb. It's just, like, an emotional thing, yeah? I'm glad you returned. Yes, your content was missed. Okay, I'm good. I sound like a crow. You wouldn't? You want to test that? I've punched someone in the face before. Spooky. Wait, actually, I have so many... Spooky, I think you're such an interesting human, and I kind of just want to, like, understand what goes on in your brain. Have you ever been in a physical altercation? Hold up. Sorry, I need to jump into a voice call for, like, 2 seconds, and then I'm leaving. Stop fucking playing Rocket League, you heathens! Oh, wait, I'm muted. Stop fucking playing Rocket League, you heathens! Sorry, my mods are playing Rocket League, and I know why they're playing Rocket League, and I I didn't know I was fucking muted in there though. You have? Why? What happened? I've been in a physical. How did I know? Because I'm friends with you on fucking Steam, Mo, and it came up, and it said Sphered Cross is playing Rocket League, and I went. Bleh! I don't hate Rocket League. I just hate when my friends play it. Also, guys, I scammed the fuck out of you, and I have to make up for it. Almost a year ago, at my fucking 1 year stream, when we reached a charity goal, I said that I'd play Rocket League, and I still haven't done it. I have to play Rocket League on stream soon. You have to hold me to this, guys. I forget. You have to yell at me. I also still have to do my Poison Ivy cosplay. But I have been insecure about my body and I haven't wanted to do it. But I'll do it soon. Wait, what's the squid lore about Rocket League? Oh, I just don't understand car soccer. I will play Overwatch on stream soon. I love Overwatch. I don't mean to scam you guys. It's just an accident. You're not so good. Thank you. I really like them. We also need to. I have the stuff for the Megamind one. We just need to do Megamind. There's a lot of stuff that we need to do. What charity did you donate to? The Trevor Project, I believe, was that stream. I've done a bunch of charity streams. We'll do another one soon. But I've kind of been into soccer lately. So I watched the World Cup. I've gotten quite into soccer. So maybe we'll do it. But no, hold on. Thank you guys. I'm going to end stream in just a minute or two because I'm a little overstimulated and I think it's time that I end for the night, and I'll be back tomorrow, 7 p.m. CST. We'll hang out, we'll have a nice little night. But there's a bunch of stuff that I need to do, and a bunch of streams we need to do, a bunch of content that I want to make. And I really appreciate you guys being so patient with me as a creator, partially because of school, but also partially because the past couple months, as a lot of you guys know, have been a really big mental health battle for me. And I know that that affects my content, and I just want to say thank you guys for being so understanding with that for me, because it is been a really rough battle the past couple months, and I know it's been harder for me to do my usual stuff, and I really appreciate you guys giving me that time. Here for you, not for the funny. The funny's the plus. We're here for you. You're doing fine. Thank you. I don't need affirmation or anything. Trust me, I'll tell you guys if I need affirmation. But I just wanted to say that I appreciate you guys, because it's really scary. I was really scared that I was like, oh, I took a break and no one's going to want to watch me anymore. Everyone's going to hate me now. And it's so easy to let those insecurities get in my head. And I just want to say thank you guys for, you know, being the cool community you are. But I'll be back tomorrow. We need to raid someone. Who do we raid? Who have I not raided in a long time? I remember when I lost my mind. Only 300 people. No, I don't saw that many people in chat. Is it really 300 people? That's crazy. Alpha, are you live? Elf, are you live? Elf, if you go live right now, I'll raid you. I'll do it. You're here all the time. Go live right now. No? Fuck you. Fine. Fine. I won't then. Huh. Okay, hold up. I want to start streaming. You should. Genuinely should. Hold up. I'm trying to find someone cool to raid. Should we raid Prezo? I've never raided them before, but they're like a cool person, right? People, yeah, they're cool, right? I've watched about 5 minutes of their content and I had fun. Let's do it. Let's raid them. I haven't done it before. Okay, I'll let me pull up my new tank. Thoughts on the new... What the fuck is that? I've never heard of that animal. Hold up. I remember when I lost my mind. Well, okay, my credits aren't working for some reason. So we're just going to do the raid. Thank you, Cobalt. Oh, the tier 3! Cobalt, I'll be back tomorrow, 7 p.m. CST. Hold up. They have follower only chat? Oh, okay. Hold up. They have follower only chat. I'm raiding someone else. I want to be able to raid. We're going to raid Hippo. We're going to raid Hippo. Hold up. Copy the raid message. We're going to raid my friend Hippo. Hippo's cool. Squid is also a singer. Not right now. My voice is going to shut. But gamers, join the raid. Copy the raid message. Copy the raid. Oh, Gideon, thank you for the gifted sub. I will be back tomorrow, 7 p.m. CST, and then Thursday. That is the plan. That is not going to change. I will update on times in the Discord. Also, Turtle, I never said hello to you, but you came in earlier and you said hi, and I mentally said hi to you. Oh, it's a Nightbot. Oh, my God. But gamers, friends, besties. Oh, look, it's working here. Thank you so much for all the subs and the love today, and for letting me take a little break. I am excited. The time in EST is an hour later, so 7 p.m. CST is 8 p.m. EST, and yeah, but I adore you guys so much, parasocially, of course, but thank you guys so much. I was really anxious about today, and I'm sorry I was a little awkward and weird, but we're all a little awkward and weird some days. I will be back tomorrow with fun stories, and we'll hang out and we'll play video games and we'll have a good time and it'll be so exciting. I enjoyed the stream. Did we have fun today? Tell me if we had fun today. And copy the raid message, fuckers. Let's have a wonderful, wonderful raid. Show some personal love. Yes? Okay. Good. We hate you. Thank you, Milton. That's what I needed right now.
I love y'all, Parasocials. Have a good raid!